The mission of the Securities and Exchange Commission is to protect investors, but did it fall down on the job over a possible conflict of interest case regarding disgraced money manager Bernard Madoff? The chairman of the House Oversight and Government Reform Committee, Darrell, Issa, thinks so, and he joins us from Capitol Hill. Mr. Chairman, great to have you here with us. So what happened, and why are you calling it a serious blow to the SEC's credibility?
Well, Carol, as you know, public confidence is everything for the SEC. Obviously, when they look into public companies and require them to have transparency, disclosure, and no conflicts of interest, particularly among their board, we take that for granted. But when the general counsel of the SEC told the chairwoman that he had taken $2 million from a Madoff fund, and then she allowed him, along with their ethics counsel, to weigh in as to the valuation of any potential clawback, and he weighed in favor of he and his family's $2 million taken out, we'd say that crossed the line. I think to be honest, the chairwoman believes so. We think that's the reason Becker resigned, but it's also the reason that we need to find out how this will be prevented in the future.
Well, this was on Mary Shapiro's watch, so cut to the chase. Do you think Mary Shapiro needs to step down here?
Well, I think today she had a bad day where she's trying to explain why she needed a 28% increase in budget, much of it because of increased regulation from Congress under Dodd-Frank. And at the same time, she didn't have a good explanation other than she had commissioned a study. She did have the IG looking at it. But candidly, this isn't over until we really understand why and how anyone could be allowed to influence the value of assets over which they had a direct interest.
All right, but let me ask you again, because we're coming off of a couple years where so many questioned the ethics of our government officials, our regulators, folks on Wall Street. So do you think, when all is said and done, that Mary Shapiro needs to step down?
Well, I think this is a serious breach by her. It has hurt my confidence in somebody who I thought a great deal of, and it does cause me to say that if it were me, I would want a better explanation than I've gotten, or I'd like her to, in fact, explain how this was not going to happen in the future, because I do think there was an error in judgment that included her. But remember, she doesn't work for me. I'm not a senator. We didn't confirm her. But I think this isn't going away until there's much more disclosure and a real belief that the SEC's culture of I don't seem to care, give me more money, changes, because this is an organization that was broken when she came in. She said she was going to fix it. 2 years in, she hasn't done so, and that concerns us.
What do you think, Congressman, though, about that request for more funds? I mean, Carol and I talk to guys on Wall Street all the time and have for years now who say the SEC has no chance against white-collar criminals. They are underfunded, they are understaffed, and there's nothing they can do without the money or the people.
Well, I appreciate that, Matt. I asked the chairwoman a very straightforward question. She gave me a partial answer, and she's going to give me the rest for the record. She said approximately 40% of her funding is going to go toward, if you will, the old work. Well, 60% of what she's asked for in additional funds and her baseload are going to go toward basically the Dodd-Frank implementation. So she made it very clear that her problem with money right now is she's outgunned by new regulations. She's going to have to implement new requirements. And in some cases, these are good. Certainly looking at the derivatives market, looking at hedge funds is important. But also, it's important to ask, why don't we make sure she's properly funded for the work she wasn't successfully doing? And I asked a number of questions for the record that she's going to return, including the fact that Dodd-Frank had no data transparency, no interoperability. She has multiple agencies that don't even require the same level of information to be shared. So there are issues that are going to continue to come. Hopefully, she'll have answers better on the record.
All right, Chairman Issa, we have to leave it. Hopefully, we can get you back real soon to talk more about this.
Of course.
Chairman Issa, thank you so much. We appreciate it.